love coming out to the pits because you never know what you're going to see. But then again, if you go to drag races on a pretty regular basis, you're going to see a couple of cars an awful lot. And General Motors F-bodies like this Pontiac Firebird B-Stock Automatic is a perfect example. But this car can really run. But what's more important is the driver. You are going to love this lady racer, Allison Doll. Allison not only is an excellent racer, but is one of the brains behind Portatree. Allie, you've been racing for quite a while. Tell us how you got into the sport.
Well, I started in junior dragsters when I was 8 years old. I actually didn't like it very much, and I took a step back. My brother jumped into my junior, started winning a ton, and I saw his trophy room, and I'm like, maybe I should do that too. When I got back in, I was 14, and I loved it, like, right from the beginning. And then I just, a natural progression, my dad ran super stock, he found me a stalker, and we ended up with this black beauty right here.
And you have gone a lot of rounds with this car. Now, I know there are a lot of Pontiac fans out there, as am I. Love keeping the brand going. This car is gorgeous, but you go a lot of rounds in this car. You won a lot of races. You go a lot of rounds. Tell me about what's under the hood and how quick it is.
So this car in B can run around, you know, 10-20s, 10-30s. Goes around 130 to 128 miles an hour. It's been as quick as a 999. I wanted to get in the nines. We managed to do it, but that's when it was an A. It has an LT1, a 350 cubic inch motor, not the LS, it's the little LT1, built by BES Racing Engines out of Indiana. They've done a great job. It has a turbo action transmission, metric 200, and that's pretty much what keeps her going.
And what year is it, 99, 98?
98. It's one of the cool years where Pontiac did kind of like what factory stock is now back in the 90s. So they sent everyone out 97 Firebirds with 97 motors. And then a year later, they sent them all new trim. So you can get away with running the LT1 motor with the 98 body.
Can we see under the hood?
Of course.
All right. Allison doing a great job all year long. Going to show us under the hood, which that's always rare. Sometimes stock eliminator is top secret stuff. So there you go. And that is a good looking power plant.
Yeah, it's excellent. It's been doing a great job this year. It's going to get ready to go back and maybe get a little more for next year, I'm hoping. But there's always something to find in stock eliminator.
Well, let's focus in on that a little bit, because we were just having a conversation about strategy in this class. It's not all pure performance. That's a big part of it. But being in the right place, running the right cars, showing up in the right class, having the right weight at the right time, that is all part of stock eliminator.
Yeah, stock eliminator is very difficult because it's about qualifying. But then once you're qualified, it's kind of a mix. It's half bracket race, half heads up racing. So at the moment's notice, if you run someone in the same class as you, you have to run heads up, and then you want to be as fast as you can be. Well, if you're in the middle of the race, the next round you come around and it's a bracket race again. You have to put a dial on the car, you have to predict what you're going to run. Well, the problem with that is if you're just going as fast as you can and now you're trying to predict what you're going to run, it can be difficult. You know, you don't exactly know, did I get it back to 100% normal? So a lot of people don't run 100% as fast as they can every round. That's hard on the engine, so we don't like to do that. So it's a lot of back and forth games in stock.
And if you find yourself in one of those heads-up races, and to me, this is one of the most exciting aspects of this, all of a sudden, you have to pull out all the stops to make your car as quick and fast as possible. What are some of the things that you guys do without revealing all of your secrets? These are things that all racers in this situation do. Give us some examples.
One thing you can do is change oil. Normally, you run a heavier oil. It helps preserve the motor better, but in a heads-up situation, you might want to run some lightweight oil. Something else you can do is put ice on the intake. You're not supposed to ice in the staging lanes, but there's nothing that says you can't ice back here. Some people I've seen have dropped their whole fuel container in like dry ice, and I've never done that. I've never tried that. I don't know if my car would like it, but it's crazy, you know, because you're allowed to get the fuel to a certain temp. It has to be over the temp when you check it at the end of the race. But before, there's nothing that says you can't do it.
Excellent. Can we see you in the car?
Sure.
Let's get in the car. And Allison doing a great job. Now, Portatree on the side. We're going to ask you about that once we get to see you in your office. And she's going to climb in. And this is one of my favorite cars. I remember when these Gen 4 F-bodies came out, Camaro, Firebird, and otherwise. I just thought it was one of the coolest cars out here. Allison, you can see you're up on the wheel. And this thing does pretty large wheel stands, doesn't it?
Oh, yes, definitely. Huge wheel stands. One of the best parts about this car.
Does the car have a name?
I call her Ladybird.
Ladybird? Where'd you come up with that?
Well, she's definitely a lady and she's a Firebird, so I just kind of conjoined the two names, I guess.
Perfect example. All right, now I notice you got some buttons and switches down there, et cetera, and you're wearing Portatree gear. Let's merge all those things together. You need to be able to practice. You can only get practice out there on the track. You and the folks at Portatree, that's your family's business, said, man, we got to make people opportunity to practice at home in their trailers, and thus Portatree is born.
Yes, my dad actually started Portatree because he wasn't cutting as good of lights as he'd like when he was going to the track. So he made test track systems where he could actually pre-stage and stage and launch his car in like his backyard. So from there, we have now like a little tabletop tree that you can just practice with hand switches and foot pedals, and complete to the full 6-foot tree that just like the tree out on the starting line here.
And some tracks even run your timing system as their actual system. Am I correct about that?
Yes, that's correct. A lot of major tracks in Australia and the Middle East, and definitely some tracks in the U.S. as well.
I notice a button in the cup holder. You've got your transmission, your shifter, and all that. This is stock eliminator, and so you got to launch with your, you know, what you came with the factory stock. Tell us about some of these gadgets you got going on.
Sure. So the big red button here is actually a master kill switch. It shuts off all power in the car. So if I was ever in a dangerous situation, I could just hit this and everything's off. The black button over here is my data recorder. The big green button actually puts the electronic shifter into pit road mode. So you can just kind of cruise around the pits and it shifts at lower RPM. Red button on the shifter is the line lock. Other than that, like the switch panel is ignition, fuel, fan, water pump, you know, the basics pretty much you find in any car, and of course the starter.
Well, I think it is great. Obviously, this car is beautiful, but I think the best story is that you went to work for your dad's company and is an electrical engineer who helped write the code and do all the different elements that help drag racers around the country. So not only are you racing, but in many ways, you're making a living and giving back to the sport.
Yes, and I love to do it. I love designing the practice trees, and the newest practice tree, the Eliminator Next Gen, which came out a few years ago, I actually went around and talked to a lot of racers to see what features they would like in a practice tree, and so that's how it was born. So if you haven't seen one, definitely check it out.
We're going to be watching you on the track. Allison Doll doing a great job in stock Eliminator. Sometimes the cars are crazy. Sometimes they're station wagons. Sometimes they're just a good old-fashioned B-stock automatic Firebird known as Ladybird.
Subscribe now